Hey guys, welcome in Mastering Angular 15 from Beginners to Advanced course. In today's lecture, we will explore Angular pipes and understand the built-in pure versus impure types. In Angular, a pipe is a simple function you can use in a template to accept an input value and return a transformed value. They allow us to take in data and modify its output, for instance, converting a string to uppercase. There are different kinds of built-in pipes: uppercase and lowercase pipe, date pipe, decimal and percent pipe, currency pipe, JSON pipe and key value pipe, and the last is slice pipe. Now let's implement these built-in pipes in our Angular application. In app component, I have created two variables, user and current time. In its HTML file, I'm going to implement all the built-in pipes. First, let's implement for the string. And I'm going to use uppercase pipe for the string. Now for this uppercase string, I'm going to use the pipe lowercase. Now for my current time variable, I'm going to use the pipe date and its value will be full date, so that it will display the full date. Next, for the decimal value, I'm going to use the percent pipe, which will convert this value into a percentage. Next, I'm going to use the JSON pipe for my user variable, which will display the JSON of this user. As you can see, it converts our first string into uppercase and second into lowercase. Then it shows the full date. Then it converts a decimal into percentage. And at last, it shows the JSON of our user variable. Now, if we want to write our own pipes for some requirements, then we can create custom pipes. And for the creation of custom pipes, we can use this command ng-generate pipe. And here I'm going to give the name of this pipe, which will be truncate. Now if we see the class of the pipe, it implementing pipe transform interface. Now if we see the transform function, it have two types of arguments and we can change it according to our requirement. Here I'm going to pass the second argument length and its default value will be 5. So that it will truncate 5 characters by default. And its return type will be string. As we want to implement it on the string value, so in if we're going to implement if value is null or type of value is not equal to string, then return empty string. Otherwise, if the value is string, then first it will check the length of the value. If the value's length is greater than the given length, then it will substring the length from 0 to given length and add these three dots after it. But if the length is less than this given length, then it will return the same value. Now if we want to use it, then we need to copy this truncate name. And I'm going to use this pipe in HTML again. First, I'm going to write a long string. And second is short, so that we can test this truncate pipe. Now, if we want to add our own string's value, then we can also do that. And to test it, I'm going to write this string. This is more than 20 characters string, and in this I'm going to pass the value 20. Now let's run the application and see it on the front end. As our first string was more than 5 characters, so it appends 3 dots after these 5 characters. And then second it print as it is, cause it was having only 4 characters. and at the end it prints 20 characters because we entered the value 20 for it. So in this way we can implement our custom pipe. Next, if we talk about the types of the pipes, then first is pure pipes. These are the most common type. They only reevaluate when the input changes. This makes them efficient. Second is impure pipes. Impure pipes might seem less efficient because they run every chain detection cycle, but they are useful in scenarios where the data changes often, like with observables. This truncate pipe which we have created, this is pure pipe. Now if we want to make it impure, then we need to write pure false here, because by default this pure is true. Next, if we talk about the advantages of using pipes, then first is data formatting. It converts raw data into user-friendly formats, for example, transforming timestamps into human-readable dates. Second is readability. It cleans templates by shifting transformations to pipes. Side-by-side comparison, a template with and without pipes. Third is declarative approach. Focus on what you want, not how to get it. For example, a transformation using component logic versus using a pipe. So this was the today's lecture. Hope you understand it. If you have any question or query, you can ask in comments. But guys, if this lecture is helpful for you, then please like, subscribe and share my channel. Thanks for watching.